Munitraya Prarthana. Yenachara samam nayam adhigamya maheshwara. Kritsnam vyakaranam proptam tasmai paninaye nama. Yena dhauta girapumsam vimalai shabdavari bihi. Tamascha jnanajam bhinnam tasmai paninaye nama. Vakyakaram vararuchim bhashyakaram patanjalim. Pāṇinim sutrakarancha pranatosmi munitrayam. Om namah Pāṇini kachayana patanjalipya. Shabdavidya sampradaya pravartakebhyo munibhyo mahabhyo gurubhyaha. Asmin varge vayam gneep prakaranam adava gneesh prakaranam anuvartayama. In this class we will continue the stri prachaya gneesh prakaranam. In the last class we have touched upon the sutram 44th. We have left some portions. Those portions also we will complete today. 4144. Oto gunavachanat. Neep iti anuvartate. Va utaha gunavachanat iti sandhi vibhagaha. Va means vikalpena. Utaha. Utaha means ukarantat. Ukarantat pradipadikat. Gunavachanat. Utaha and gunavachanat are the adjectives of pratipadikam. Ukarantat pratipadikat. Gunavachanat pratipadikatya. So the sutra's meaning is this. Ukarantat gunavachinaha va gneesh pratyayo bhavati striyam ichartha. Actually here we are supposed to continue gneesh, because in the earlier sutra shridh gauradibhyascha, starting with that sutra gneesh is continuing. Anuvurtihi. Here also naturally gneesh will continue, but because of a vartikam we are going to tell gunavachanat gneep adyudattartha iti vartikam pathyate. Tena gunavachanat gneepeva bhavati iti nirdharativyam. So we are here anuvrutti will be gneep, not gneesh. The fact is, whether it is gneep or gneesh, swarupam is the same. Their shape of the word is the same, but there is only difference in the swara. Adyudattartham gneep. So here, we take gneep. So we have to take gunavachanas. Gunavachanam means gunam vakti iti gunavachanam. That is, it tells about a quality. We have got some kinds of words. Gunavachanaha, dravyavachanaha, kriyavachanaha, etc. Gunavachanaha means those words describing quality. Dravya means those words describing a matter. Kriyavachana means those words describing an action. So here we have to take the example of gunavachanam, the pratipadikam which is gunavachanam, and ukarantaha. Mrudu. Mrudu means soft. Soft natured. Soft. Mrudu tasmat gneep. Mrudu plus e. Anadeshaha. Mrudvi bhavati. Because this is vikalpena, this action, grammatical action is alternatively available. So instead of nip, we have made mrudvi, nip na bhavati cha. So if it is not there, simply the word will subsist, mruduhu. Strilinge mruduhu mrudvi cha. Likewise, ukaranta guru shabdaha. Guru, we are not taking teacher here. We are taking the quality. Guru means large, big. Nipi krute gurvi iti bhavati, anadeshena. If the stripracheya is not there, guruhu. Laghu. Laghu is opposite of guru. Laghuhu laghvi. Patuhu patvi. So all these things we have explained in the last class. Now we will take up one vartikam. Vasu shabdat gunavachanat gneep adyutatardham iti vartikam. Vasu shabdat gunavachanat. When vasu shabda is used as a word expressing quality, tasmat gneep vaktavyaha. So vasu, we have to take the quality. But means rich charthaha. But the substance which has got the richness is also called vasu. We are not concerned with that now. Vasu is dravya vachakena asmakam sambandho nasti as far as this vartikam is concerned. So vasu shabdat neep. Vasvi bhavati. Anadeshena. Another vartikam. Kharu samyogopadhat na. This is actually prohibiting the grammatical action prescribed in the main sutra. Karu samyogopadhat. There are two words. Karu. Karu shabdat nipna bhavati. Striyam nipna bhavati. Striyam pracheyasya avasyakata evanasti. Karu itself is strilinga shabda. Karu and samyogopadhat. A pratipadikam having upadha as a samyogacharam. Having samyogacharam as upadha. Upadha means last but one word. That is, if it is samyogacharam, that is a letter containing at least two consonants, then tasmat ni prachayo navavati. Let us take the examples. Karu. Stri pracheha na bhavati. Karuhu. Iti shabdarupam bhavati. Striyam api karuhu eva. Striyam karuhu means patimvara kanya. It has got a specific meaning. Patimvara kanya. The girl who chooses her own husband. She is called karu. The example, a sentence is given as an example. Karuriyam brahmani. This Brahmin girl has a husband selected by herself. The next word is samyogopadhat. Samyoga upadha yasya. We will take a word having quality. Pandu shabdaha. Pandu means varna, white colored. So, color also is a quality. So, pandu tasmat gneep na bhavati, stri prachayopi na bhavati. Panduhu means sveta ichardhaha, white. Panduriyam brahmani. This Brahmin girl is white complexioned. Pandu shabdat stri prachayaha nasti. Now, let us go to the next sutra. Bahvadibhyascha. Nish va striyam. They will continue in this sutra. Bahuadibhyascha. Bahu plus adi is bahuadi. So there is a particular gana which we are going to discuss afterwards. Bahu with starting with Bahu, the first word in that Gana is Bahu. So that is called Bahuadi Ganaha. Bahuadi Ganebhyaha, Bahuadi Ganastha Shabdebhyaha, Striyam Gnish Vikalpena Bhavati. Bahu Icheva Madayaha Pratipadikebhyaha, Striyam Vagnish Bhavati. If you take the first word in that, Bahu, Bahu, Bahuhu, or Bahu plus Gnish, Bahu plus E, Bahvi, Anadeshaha, Bahuhu, Bahvi, both are acceptable. Here, we get a doubt. Bahu is a Gunavachanam. Voto Gunavachanatiti Purva Sutrena Gunavachana Gunavachanepyaha Pratipadikepyaha Vikalpena Stri Prachayo Bhavati Iti Uktameva Tena Eva Etad Bahushabdasya Stri Prachayaha Siddhyati. Then why it is again mentioned? The point is here, Bahushabda has got two meanings. It has got a, in respect of quality, it has got the meaning plentiful, much, abundant, great. These are all gunavachanas. They tell the quality. But this Bahu Shabda can be used as a number also. In great number, many ichyarthe. So, probably this is taken again in this Bahuadi Gana. The Bahu Shabda, both as Gunavachanam as well as Sankhyavachanam, it deserves Gnish Prachayaha. So if you take Sankhyavachanam, Bahu plus E, Bahvi, Bahvi iti, this Bahuvachana in Sankhya, it will be only, it is only in plural number. It is not used in the ekavachanam or divachanam. So, plural prathama vibhaktau ekavachane prathama vibhaktau rupe bahvyaha iti bhavanti. Bahvyaha striyaha, many ladies icharthe. Saptami ekavachanam, saptami bahuvachanam bahvishu. Bahvishu strishu, in many women icharthe. Another point also is there in taking this Bahu Shabda in this Gana again. Bahu Shabdasya Pathaha Uttarartha. In the next sutra, Bahulam Nityam Chandasi is we are going to discuss. In that sutra, only this Bahu Shabda is to be taken. That is why it is separately taken in this sutra. Now we will read this Bahuadi Ganaha. Bahu already we have dealt. The second word is Paddhati. Paddhati. Ikaranta Shabdaha. This gets Gnish Vikalpena. Paddhatihi Paddhaticha. If it gets Gnish, Paddhati, Paddhati plus E, Paddhati. Doesn't get Sri Prachaya Paddhatihi. Now we are going to get a Gana Sutram in this Gana. Krid Ikarad Aktinaha iti Gana Sutram Uchete. So Krudanta Prachayaha Aktin Prachayaha Ikaranta Prachayaha. That also will get. Here, Aktinaha Ichuktam. Different from Tin Prachaya. Ikaranta Kritu Prachayantaha Ikarantaha. Other than Tin. So, if you take this Paddhati as a Tin, this cannot get Nish. Because Krid Ikarat Aktinaha Iti Ganasutram Uchyate. So, Tinnantanam Stri Prachayaha Nabhavati. Because Striyam Tinniti Sutrena Tinnanta Shabdaha Striyameva Uchyate. tadardham punaha stri pracheya yojanam tatra anavashyakam bhavati. But here we are taking this gnish also. Paddhatihi paddhati gnishantam. Because this paddhati shabda will not get gnish ordinarily because of this prohibition of tinnanta. In order to make it get this gnish vikalpena, that has been added in this sutra. So paddhatihi paddhativa. What is the meaning of paddhatihi? Margaha ichyarthaha. Padd plus hati is to be divided. Padd means pada. Hati means beaten. The road which is hit by the feet of pedestrians is called road. Margaha. How this word is formed? Paddhati shabdaha tinnantaha. Pada iti upapadam. Han dhatoha kti pracheha. Han plus ti. There the nakara anunasika will get dropped. Anudatopadesha vanati tanochadinam anunasika lopaha. Iti sutrena anunasikasya lopo bhavati. So han plus ti iti stite hati bhavati. So tinnantatvat na jnish bhavat cheva. So tinnantat ganasutra anusaram nishi aprapte tam vidhatumeva asya grahanam asmin sutre. So paddhatihi paddhativa. And next is this ganasutram. Earlier we have referred. Krud ikarad aktinaha. Aktinaha means different from ktin, other than ktin. Other than ktin, ikarant shabda will get gnish as a vikalpa. So, for other than ktin, let us take some words, examples. Ratri shabdaha. Ratri means night. What is the utpatti of this ratri shabdaha? It is not tin antam. Ra dane iti dhatoho aunadika pracheyaha, trip pracheyaha. So ra plus tri, ratri bhavati. This is not gunavachanam. And this is not ukaranta also. So gnish is not obtained here. That is tadartham eva atra gane etat patitam asti. Sarvataha aktinardhakat iti eke. This is also a part of the sutram. Sarvataha aktinardhakat iti eke. Kechana vayakaranaha uchyante uchya vadanti sarvataha bhavati aktinardhakanam sarvatra etad vikalpo bhavati iti vadanti. Tena api krud ikaranta, this is ikaranta shabdaha, aktin shabdaha, so jnish vikalpena bhavati. Ratrihi athava ratri. Ratrihi iti na bhavati ched, stri pracheha. Jnish bhavati ched ratri iti ikaranta shabdaha. Evam aktin shabdaha, some more examples we'll take. Shakati shabdaha. This is not tinantam. Ikaranta strilinga shabdaha. So this gets gnish vikalpena. Shakatihi athava shakati. This is shakati shabdaha. It is in fact taken as a abhyutpanna pradipadikam. This is krudantam nabhavati. Sarvataha iti guna ganasutra muktam iti krutva tena karanena atra vagnish bhavati. Another example is anguli shabdaha, ikaranta shabdaha. This is not tinnantam. This gets gnish alternately, vikalpena. Angulihi anguli. Anguli means finger. Aktinardhakaha. Ankati shabdaha, aktin. Ankatihi ankati. Ankati means wind. Fire. Anchati shabdaha. Anchatihi anchati vikalpena. Anchati means wind. Amhatihi Amhati. Amhati means a gift, a donation, ichartha. Vamhati ikaranta srilinga shabdaha. Vamhatihi Vamhati. Vikalpena jnish. Increase ichartha. Again, another Gana Sutra. Shaktihi Shastre. Shakti iti shabdaha. Shastrardhe gnish svikaroti. Shastre abhideye. Shastre ichartha. Shastra means ayudham. Shastre abhideye vagnish bhavati. So, shaktihi ikaranta shabdaha. Shaktihi Shakti. This Shakti is not general Tinnartha. In Tinnartha, only Shakti is available. Because already it is in Strilinge, Striyam Tiniti. So this Shakti, it only means Shastram, Ayudham. For example, in Mahabharata, we come across this name, Indra. In return for the Kavacha and Kundala donated to him by Karna, he gives him this Shakti Shastram, Ayudham. And also put some restrictions stating that this can be used only once. Later in the Mahabharata story, Karna wanted to use this only for defeating his arch rival Arjuna. But unfortunately, due to pressure from Duryodhana, he had to use it to annihilate Ghatotkacha. So, he lost the chance of using this weapon against Arjuna. So, Shaktihi Samarjhamicharthe Shakdhatohoktin Prachayaha, that will not get Gnis. Because already it is in Strilinga. Shaktihi Samarjham. Another example of ikaranta shabdaha, shari. This also gets vikalpena gnish. Shari. Sharihi, shari means pakshi visheshaha. Sarika pakshi. Vari shabdaha, ikarantaha. Varihi vikalpena gnish. Vari. Vari means a chain to bind the elephants to a pole, pillar. Again, the generally used vari shabda, that is in ikaranta napumsakalinga shabda, that means jalam. This vari means a chain to tie the elephants. And then you get another word, ahi shabda, ikaranta ahi shabda. This gets vikalpena gnish, ahihi ahi, that means a sea serpent. Kapi shabdaha, alternately means kapihi kapi, shri monkey ichartha. Muni shabdaha, muni striyam, munihi otherwise muni, a lady saint. Yasti shabdaha, yasti means a stick, yastihi yasti. Again, a ganasutram. Itaha pranyangat. Ikarantat pradipadikat pranyanga vachinaha vagnish bhavati. If the pradipadikam with the ikaranta, ending with the ikara, and also prani angavachi, that means the word relating to the limb of a living being. So, this gets vikalpena gnish. The examples are dhamani shabdaha, dhamani. Dhamani means a vein, a nerve of the human body through which blood flows. Dhamani hi, dhamani, vikalpena gnish, dhamani. Nadi shabdaha, nadi also a part of the, a limb of the body, a tubular organ of the body, such as artery, vein, etc. Nadi shabdaha, nadihi, nadi, vikalpena gnish. Nabhi shabdaha, nabhihi, nabhi, the navel of human body. Anguli Shabdaha, already we got it, Angulihi Anguli, a finger of the body. And then another word, Chanda Shabdaha, this gets Vikalpena Gnis, Chandi, or because this is Akaranta Shabda, that gets top also, Chanda, Chanda Chandi, an angry lady. Arala Shabdaha, Arala Shabdaha, Akarantaha. This gets a gnish alternatively. So Arali, Adhava, because of Akaranta, top, Arala. Arala, Arali means a bent or a crooked arm. Sometimes this Akaranta Srilinga Shabda, it also means Arala, an unchaste woman, a harlot. Another word, Akaranta Shabdaha, Kamala Shabdaha. Alternatively, Jnish, Kamali Bhavati, otherwise, top, Akaranta Tvat. Kamala, Kamali, a lotus. Krupana Shabdaha, Krupanaha, Krupani, a sword. Vikata Shabdaha, Vikata means an ugly thing. Vikata, Vikati, Jnish, alternatively. Otherwise, I mean, when Gnish is not applicable, top. Vishala Shabdaha, Vishala Vishali, a large thing, a great thing, a broad thing. Vishankata Shabdaha, this also means great, large, strong, powerful. Vishankata Vishankati. Bharuja Shabdaha, this means a jackal. Bharuja or Bharuji. Bharuji in case of Gnish. Bharuja in case of top. A sea jackal. Then again, a Ganasutram or earlier Dhvaja Shabdaha. Akaranta Dhvaja Shabdaha. Dhvaja means a flag or a symbol. A symbol of a warrior or a symbol of a nation. Dhvaja Shabdaha. Nish bhavati chet dhvaji bhavati, top bhavati chet bhaja. Ganasutram, Chandra bhagat nadyam. Chandra bhaga iti shabda dhanantaram, nadyam ityarthe, when it is the name of a river, it gets the gnish alternatively, vikalpena gnish bhavati. Gnish bhavati chet chandra bhagi bhavati, gnish na bhavati chet akarantatvat top bhavati. Chandra Bhaga. Again, Kalyana Shabdaha. Kalyana. Nish Kalyani. Or top. Kalyana. Kalyana Stri. Kalyani Stri. Udara Shabdaha. Udara means large. Udara Udari. Top or Nish. Purana Shabdaha. Purana means old. Purani Nish. Purana top. Ahan Shabdaha. Ahan means a day. Ayam Shabdaha kevala hastriyam navartate. Tasmat samasante eva bhavati. Samasanta udaharanam dirghaha ahaha yasya ichardhe dirghaha dirghahan dirghahni. If it is gnish, it is dirghahni. If it is top, Dirghahna, Dirghani Ahani Yasyam Sharadi Sa Dirghahni. Here Nakara, it gets Nakara because of Refa. Then let us go to the next sutra. Nityam Chandasi. Nityam Chandasi. That means Bahwadibhyaha Anuvartate Striyam Gnish. Bahuadibhyaha, Pradipadikebhyaha, Chandasi Visaye, that means Veda Bhashaya, Gnish Striyam Gnish Nityam Bhavati Ichartha. Purvam Vikalpena Praptam, Idanim Veda Bhashaya Nityam Prapnoti. So, one mantra we will cite as example. Bahvi Suhitva Prapivan. That means Bahvi Nama Osadhi. Osadhyaha Nama. Nityam Grahanam. Why this Nitya Grahanam Kritam here? Earlier all Vikalpena. By this Nitya Grahana, this will continue in the other sutras following. Nityam Grahanam Uttarartham. Now let us go to the next sutra, 47th. Bhuvascha Chandasi Iti Vartate. Nityam Nish. Veda Bhashayam Chandasi Vishaye Striyam Bhu Iti Shabdasya Nityam Nish Bhavati. Here, Bhuvascha Iti Bhuvaha, we have to take the word Bhu, Sarasvantam, not Bhu, Dirghantam. Bhu Shabdat Nish Bhavati. Vibhu Shabdaha. Vibhu Ukaranta, Hraswa Ukaranta Shabdaha. Vibhu means Lord. Vibhu Tasmat Gnish. Vibhu plus E. Yanadeshaha. Vibhi. Prabhu. Prabhu also means Lord, King. Prabhu plus Gnish. Prabhvi. Then Swayambhuhu iti Shabde Atra Bhu Shabdasya Gnish Nakritam. Kimardham Nakritam Atra Dirghanta Shabdaha. Dirgha Ukarantaha. Taparakaranam Kritam. Chandasi Visaye Striyam Bhuvo Nityam Gnish Bhavati. Taparakaranam, take that taparakaranam right from 44th sutra. So in 44th sutra, taparam was done. So if you take that taparakaranam here, then ukaranta uta taparakaranam kutam cheta hraso ukaranta deva bhushabdasya etat nish bhavati natu dirgha ukaranta shaiti. Now let us go to the next sutra. Umyogad akhyayam gnish iti anuvartate. Pumyogat akhyayam. Pumyogat iti ekah shabdaha. Akhyayam iti aparaha shabdaha. Akhyayam means akhya ichukte akhyayate anena iti akhya. The name by which the person is called Agya. Agya simply means name. In respect of name, Ichardhaha. Pumyogat. Pumyoga, this is to be understood. Pumman, Pum Ichukte Puman, male. Pumyogaha Ichukte Pumsa Yogaha. When this name is related to a male, when the female word is related to, is a female word is used in relating to a female, relating to a male, if that is there, it is called Pumyoga. So Pumyogad Achyaya. Pumyogad Hetoho Yat Pradipadikam Striyam Vartate Pumsaha Akhyabhutam Yah Shabdaha Vartate Tasmat Gnish Pratyayo Bhavati Ichardha. That means the Pratipadika word meaning a male which relates to a female and expresses a female. That name word of the male which ends in Akara will be suffixed by Gnish Pratyaya to express a female relating to himself. So, the relationship with the male person is important here. Now, let us take some examples. Ganakasya Stri. A Stri relating to Ganaka. We can as well take Ganakasya Bharya Icharthe. Ganaka means astrologer. Ganakasya Bharya, Ganakasya Stri, Pumyogat. Ganakena yogat ganaka shabdat stri. Ganakasya stri icharthe ganaka plus e gnish. Then it becomes ganaki. Ganaki Nama, the wife of the astrologer. Mahamatrasya Stri, Bharya. Mahamatraha means chief minister. The most important minister in Amatyas is called Mahamatra. Mahamatrasya Stri, Bharya. Icharthe, Mahamatra, Tasmat, Gnish. Mahamatri, the chief minister's wife, Icharta. Prashtasya Stri, Bharya. Icharthe, Prashta Shabdat, Gnish. Prashta means chief, foremost, a leader, Icharta. Prashtasya Stri, Icharthe, Prashta plus Gnish, Prashti. Prashti is the wife of a chief, principal, or foremost are a leader Icharta. Pracharasya Stri, Bharya, Icharthe, Prachari. Pracharaha means a forerunner, going in the forefront. The wife of that gentleman is called Prachari. So this Ganaka, Mahamatra, Prashta, Prachara, ete sarve shabdaha, pum shabdaha. They relate to male persons. Tad yogat striyam vartante. Then let us examine a counter example. Pum yoga aditi kim? Why this pum yoga is mentioned here? Where the strilinga shabda has no relationship with the same pum linga shabda in respect of food connection with him, that is in the meaning of bharya or in the meaning of stri relating to him, then this will not get a gnish. Example is Devadatta. Devadatta Shabdat, top. Because this is not, Devadatta does not mean Devadatta's wife. A lady called Devadatta. Yajnadatta, a lady called Yajnadatta, not Yajnadatta's wife, Yajnadatta. Here, gnish we are not getting, we are getting only top. Then, Akhya Grahanam Kim, why this Akhya is named here? That is, why only in respect of name? That means, the name given to a male person should be a name only, not a simply adjective. For example, you will take the examples, Parisrishta Shabdaha. Parisrishta means entirely left off icharta. Pari purvaka srujidhatuhu tasmat tapracheha parisrushtaha left off icharta. Parisrushta iti pumlinge bhavati tasmat strilinge parisrushta iti top bhavati. Because parisrushta is not the name of that male person, it is an adjective. Parisrushta stri. Parisrushtaha puman, Parisrushta stri. Prajata, here there is no pum yoga also. Prajata shabdaha. Prajata means born well. Prakarshena jataha. Prajata shabdat top bhavati prajata. Because prajata is not the name of a male person. Another vartikam will take up. Gopalakadinam siddhaye pratishedha. So, Gopalakasya stri ityarthe srilinga shabdasya vyutpattaye asya pratishedha kartavyaha. Kasya pratishedha gnisityasya pratishedha. That is being done by vartika. Why? Gopalakadinam siddhaye. Gopalaka's wife. Gopalaka means a cowherd, male person. That man's wife. Gopalaka plus nis pratishiddhaha. So, top bhavati. Gopalaka plus a. Gopalaka bhavati. Pratyayasthat kat purvasya ataha it. Api asupaha iti sutrena. When this top prachayasya ka is there, the akara before kaprachaya that gets converted to ikara. So gopalaka will become gopalika. Gopalika means gopalakasya patni. To arrive at this shabda gopalika, we require top. That is why gnish is prohibited here. Another vartikam says, Suryadi devatayam shap vaktavyaha. What does it mean? Surya shabdat, Suryadi shabdanam devatayam visaye. Suryascha stri ichyarthe. If she is also a devata, Surya is a devata. Suryascha stri ichyarthe. If the female also is a devata, then chop is the prachaya to be used. Chop means a. Suryasya deva, Suryasya stri devata. Surya plus a. Surya. Why this devata is told here? If it is a manushi, suppose Suryasya wife, Suryasya bharya, yadi manushi bhavati, if Surya's wife is only a manushi, that is a female existing in the world, then if it is not a devata, then only nis will be given. That is Surya plus nis. Here, Surya plus nis, here yakara is dropped. Surya tishya Agastya Mastyanam iti sutrena yakara lopaha bhavati. So Sura plus Surya yakara lopaha Suri bhavati nish prachayena. Suri means Suryasya patni manushi ichartha na devata. Suri is, she is the, it is a name given to Kunti, because Kunti, because of the prabhavaye of a mantra gifted to her by a Maharshi, she remembers Surya Devata. So he, Surya comes down and gifts her with a son. So Suri is, it is Kunti's Visheshanam. Then whether it is top or chop, same rupam, because of chop it, a special type of swara is there. That is why a chop is done here. Now let us go to the next sutra. Indra, Varuna, Bhava, Sharva, Rudra, Mrida, Hima, Aranya, Yava, Yavana, Matula, Acharyanam, Anuk. Striyam. Gnish iti anvartate. Indra, Varuna, Bhava, Sharva, Rudra, Mrida. Ete bhyaha pradipadike bhyaha. Hima, Aranya, Yava, Yavana, Matula, Acharya. Ete bhyascha pradipadike bhyaha. Striyam gnish bhavati. Tat sannivesena Anukiti agamo bhavati. In Striya, in Stri Ardha, Indrasya Stri, Varunasya Stri, Bhavasya Stri, Ichadi Ardheshu, Gnish bhavati. Along with that, Anuk agamaha. Anuk means An, that is the agama. Indradibhyaha pradipadikebhyaha. Striyam gnish prachayo bhavati, anuk cha agamaha bhavati. Anuk means an. Indra, Varuna, Bhava, Sharva, Rudra, Mruda, Matula, Acharya. Ete shabdaha, pumsi shabdaha. They all relate to males. So, in respect of these words, this prachaya is used tasya bharya icharthe. But in the respect of Hima, Aranya, Yava and Yavana, in respect of these pradipadikas, Tasya Bharya. That is not the meaning given because it is absurd. Himasya Bharya na bhavati, Aranyasya Bharya na bhavati. So, Hima, Aranya, Yava, Yavana, iti etebhyaha, pratipadikebhyaha, yasmin ardhe, nisva bhavati, adhava anukva bhavati, tad anantaram vartikayoho uchyante. Let us wait for the vartikas. Now let us take the Indra, Varuna, etc. Indrasya stri icharthe, Indrasya bharya icharthe, Indra plus an plus gnish, Indran plus e, Indrani bhavati, Refadanantaram nakarasya nakaro bhavati. Indrani, Indrani means wife of Indra. She is otherwise called Sachi Devi. Varunasya Stri Bharya Ityardhe Varunani. Varuna plus An plus Gnish. Varunani. Bhavasya Patni Ityardhe Bhavasya Bharya Ityardhe Bhavani. Bhava means Paramashiva, Ishvara. Bhavani, otherwise called Parvati. Sharva, Sharva also means Ishvara. Sharva plus An plus Gnish, Sharvani. Atrapi Nakarasya Natvam, because it is followed by, it is preceded by Repha. Sharvani, Sharvani also means Parvati. Rudra, Rudra also relates to Shiva. Rudrani Parvati. Mrida also relates to Shiva. Mridani. Then about Hima and Aranya, there is a particular vartika. Himaranyayoho mahatve gnish bhavati anukagamo bhavati. Hima, in respect of the word Hima, Hima means ice. In respect of the word Aranya, Aranya means forest. Etayoho mahatve icharthe gnish bhavati anukya agamo bhavati. Mahad himam. Mahad himam means a great amount of ice. Mahad himam. Hima plus an plus nish. Himani. Mahad aranyam. A great forest. A wide large forest. Aranya plus an plus nish. Aranyani. Another vartikam. In respect of Yava Shabda, Yavat Doshe, Doshi Icharthe, Yava Shabdat Gnish Bhavati, Anukcha Agamo Bhavati. So, Dushtaha Yava, Yava is a race which have invaded, which tried to invade India in ancient times. Yava, it was a word signifying Greeks, because Greeks were the very first people who have invited us, like Alexander, etc. So, Dushtaha Yavaha Icharthe, a cruel Yava Icharthe, Yava plus An plus E, Nis, Yavani. This is not a Strilinga Shabdaha. Yavani means a cruel Yava. Yavanat Lipyam. Yavana Shabdat Pradipadikat. Lipi Icharthe. Lipi means script. Lipyam Icharthe. Nish Bhavati. Anukya Agamo Bhavati. Yavana plus An plus E. Yavanani. The Lipi, the script of Yavana Bhasha. Greek language, Yavanani. Then Upadhyaya and Matula. Upadhyaya Matula Abhyam Va. Purvena Sutrena Nityam Prapnoti Vartikena Upadhyaya Shabdat Matula Shabdatcha Vikalpena Prapnoti. So Upadhyayani Anukagamaha Gnish, Upadhyaya Shabdat, Upadhyayani. Otherwise, only Anuk is a Vikalpena, Upadhyayi Bhavati. Upadhyayi and Upadhyayani, both mean Upadhyaya's wife, a teacher's wife. Matula Shabdaha, Matula means maternal uncle. Matulani, Anuk Gnish, Matulani. Only Gnish, Matuli. Matulani or Matuli means maternal uncle's wife. Another vartikam in respect of Acharya. Acharyat Anatvam cha. After Acharya Shabda, Mish Bhavati, Anukagamo Bhavati, but Nakarasya Natvam na Bhavati. Acharya plus An plus E. Acharyani. Generally, because it is preceded by Repha, Nakara should get Nakara. But here, because of this Vartikam, Nakara does not get Nakara. Acharyani. Adhava, if top is used, Acharya. Another Vartikam, it relates to newly coined, newly given words. Arya Kshetriya Bhyam Va. Arya and Kshetriya, they are not part of the Sutra. That is why a separate Vartikam has been written. Arya Kshetriya Bhyam Va. Vikalpena Gnish Bhavati. Arya means a person, a male of Vaishya community is called Arya. Kshetriya, a male person belonging to Kshetriya Varna is called Kshetriya. Arya Kshetriya Abhyam. Abhyam, Pradipadika Abhyam. Anuk plus Gnish, Vikalpena Bhavati. Arya Aryani. Adhava Aryani Eva. Natu Aryani. Aryani. Aryani means a Vaishya's wife. Adhava Arya. Kshetriyani. Kshetriya plus An plus E. Kshetriyani or Kshetriya. Kshetriya's wife. These things, this Arya Kshetriya, they have no relationship with Pumyoga. Swardheva. That means Kshetriyani or Aryani means a lady born in Vaishya family or a lady born in Kshetriya family. A Kshetriya's wife Ichardhena Bhavati. Another Vartikam, Mudgalat Chandasi Litcha. Mudgala Shabdat, Mudgala Iti Pradipadikat, Veda Bhashaya, Stri Pracheye, Anukagamaha, Nish Pracheyopi Bhavati. Lit Swaramapi Bhavati Tasya. Swaravishayaha. A mantra is being read. Rathihi Abhut Mudgalani Gavishthau. Rugveda mantra. Mudgala Shabdat Gnish Anugagamaha. Mudgalani Lit Swaraha. Antya Ikaraha Udattaha Bhavati. Lit Swara means Antya Ikaraha Udattaha Bhavati. Mudgalasya Bharya Icharthe. Now let us take the next sutram. Kritat karana purvat striyam gnishit vartate. Kritat karana purvat. Krita shabdaha. Krita means kri iti dhatoho taprachyaha. Bought, purchased icharthe. Krita shabdaha. That means kritat means krita shabdantat icharthaha. Krita shabdantat pradipadikat. Karanapurvat. That krita shabdanta pradipadika should be karanapurvaha. That means karanardhavachaka shabdaha should be before that krita shabdaha. So first karanardhavachaka shabdaha. Karanardham means kartrukaranayoho tritiya. Tritiya vibhakchanta padaha. Tritiya vibhakchanta padaha should be in the forefront. And then later, Krita Shabda should be there. against that pratipadika, gnis bhavati striyam. Udaharanam is vastrena kriyate sa icharthe vastra kriyata tasmad gnis vastra kriyati bhavati. Vastra kriyata plus gnis vastra kriyati vastrena kriyate. It purchased this type of this article which is in Srilinga is purchased by giving a vastra in return. That is, it was a barter system, olden days. Vasanena kriyate, vasana also means vastra. Vasanena kriyate sa ichyarthe vasana kriyata plus gnis vasana kriyati. Karana purvaditi kim sustukrita ichyarthe sukrita atra tapeva bhavati. Because sustu shabdaha, it is not dvitiyanta shabdaha, karanam nasti. So when it is preceded by sustu shabda, krita shabda will not get gnish, but it gets top. Sustukrita ichyarthe sukrita top. Dustukrita ichyarthe duskrita. Then we will take a particular sentence where this grammatical rule has not been applied. Sahitasya dhanakrita pranebhyopi gariyasi kasyachana kavehe vakyam. Sahitasya dhanakrita pranibhyopi gariyasi. That means here dhanakrita is tabantam is made here. Why it is not? Because this is dhanena krita icharthe, karana purvam eva asti, krita shabda asti. Kintu atra dhana krita iti, why nish is not applied here? Iti down, ashanka bhavati. Krita shabdena dhana shabdena cha samasaha. Tena gatikara kopa padanam krudbhissaha samasa vachanam prak subutpattehe iti sutrena. This is upapada, dhana is upapada. So upapada samasaha krudbhissaha, this krita is krudprachayantaha samasa vachanam prak subutpattehe iti nyayena tad tap bhavati dhanakrita dhanashabdena krita shabdasya samasaha kartrukarane krita bahulam iti sutrena atra samasaha. So having finished this sutram, let us take another sutram. Tad alpakhyayam, 51st. Tat alpakhyayam karanapurvat pradipadikat nishiti anuvartante. Tat means taprachayanta shabdat. This is the visheshanam of pradipadikam. The pradipadikam should be tanta shabdantaha, taprachayanta shabdantaha. And this should be in alpakhya. Alpakhya means alpa, means a few icharthe. A few, very little icharthe, alpa. Akhya means it means alpa. So, karanapurvat pradipadikat tantat alpakhyayam nish pratyayo bhavati. Alpakhya, to which it relates pratyayantam krutva yaha samudayaha bhavati utpannaha bhavati saha alpakhyayam bhavati. The example is abhravilipti dyauhu. Abhravilipti vipurvaka lip dhatu, lipa upadehe, tasmat taprachayaha, tasmat nish, vilipti, abhra vilipti jauhu. The sky is having a very few clouds. So here, a very few visheshanam is there. That is why here, this gnish is used, abhra vilipti. Abhraihi vilipta plus gnish, abhra vilipti. மேகைஹி விரலைஹி ஆவுருதஹா இச்சர்த்தா. சூப விலிப்தி பாத்ரா அல்ப சூப்பா இச்சர்த்தா. திஸ் வெஸ்ஸல் ஹஸ் காட் வெரி லிட்டில் சூப்பா. சூப்பா மீன்ஸ் போட்ரிட்ஜ். தி வெஸ்ஸல் வித் எ லிட்டில் போட்ரிட்ஜ் இஸ் கால்டு சூப விலிப்தி. சூப விலிப்த சப்தாத் க்னீஸ். அல்பாக்யாயாம் இது கிமர்த்தம் டோல்டு சந்தனானுலிப்தா பிராமணி. இயர் சந்தனேன அனுலிப்தா கரணபூர்வாதேவ தாந்த பிரச்சயா. கிந்து சந்தனா இஸ் நாட் எ லிட்டில் ஹியூஜ் லார்ஜ் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் சந்தனா. ஸோ சந்த திஸ் பிராமின் லேடி ஃபுல்லி ஸ்மியர்டு வித் சாண்டல் வுட். தென் ஹியர் யூ ஹவ் காட் ஓன்லி டாப் நாட் எ க்னீஸ். அல்பாக்யா மீன்ஸ் மீனிங் எ லிட்டில். இட் இஸ் நாட் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஹியர் சந்தனானுலிப்தா மச்சே. A little is not meant, so it gets top. So with this, we'll come to the end of this lesson. Om Sahanavavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Mavidvishavahai. ஓம் சாந்தி சாந்தி சாந்தி.